Hello friends, today we are going to read about packaging of DNA molecule in a eukaryotic cell. It is a very important concept with both point of view as well as with point of view of competitions. It is a very simple concept though, but it is repeatedly asked. So we must know what is the need of packaging of DNA and how do we package a DNA in a eukaryotic cell. Beginning with, DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid, which has a structure of a double-stranded helix, as we read in the chapter of molecular basis of genetics. It is circular in a prokaryotic cell. It is linear in a eukaryotic cell. In a eukaryotic cell, this particular double helical linear DNA is coiled around a protein called histone. And we say that DNA is complexed with histone protein. Vice versa, in a prokaryotic cell, this DNA is not associated with histone protein and is not organized into chromosomes. Please mark my word, chromosomes are formed only in eukaryotic cell with the help of packaging of DNA along with histone protein. Proteins are polymeric molecules which are formed by joining of amino acids. Histone is a basic protein which is joined by certain basic amino acids, and the major basic amino acids are lysine and arginine. Again, a very important one marker question. Ki histone is a basic protein formed of basic amino acids lysine and arginine. As from the chemistry basics, we know that a base is a molecule which is going to bring about a positive charge on any chemical. If I say that my amino acid is basic, what charge is it going to attain? It is going to attain a positive charge. If such amino acids combine together and form a protein, what charge will that protein take up? It is going to take a positive charge. So we can say histone is a positively charged basic protein. Now, according to physical concepts, so we have chemistry, we have physics in biology, that anything which has a positive charge is going to get attracted to an opposite charge containing entity, that is something which is negatively charged. And which chemicals take up a negative charge? Just opposite to base, we have acids which take up negative charge, and as the name suggests for DNA, it is deoxyribonucleic acid. This deoxyribonucleic acid has an acidic charge because the phosphoric acid which is attached to each nucleotide of the DNA molecule donates H plus ions and hence take up a positive negative charge. So we say DNA is a deoxyribonucleic acid. Why do we call it an acid? Because it donates H plus ions. From which part? From the phosphate part of the nucleotide, the monomeric unit of the nucleic acid. जैसे proteins polymers हैं, amino acid से जुड़-जुड़ कर बनते हैं, likewise DNA भी एक polymer है, जो nucleotide से जुड़-जुड़ कर बनता है. हर nucleotide में एक ribose sugar होती है, एक nitrogenous base होता है, एक phosphate होता है, which is derived from phosphoric acid. This phosphate donates H plus ions and takes up a negative charge, because of which we say that our DNA are acidic molecules and attain a negative charge. Since both DNA and histone are opposite charges, DNA is negatively charged, histone is positively charged. So they both attract each other and DNA coils around the histone protein, right? So we can say that if I have a negatively charged entity, it is going to get attracted to a positively charged basic protein. And this attraction of DNA to the histone protein leads to the production of a structure which is called nucleosome, my dear. We say that during packaging of DNA in a eukaryotic cell, the negatively charged DNA molecule wraps around the positively charged histone protein to form a structure called nucleosome. We can say this results in, if I consider the spherical ball as histone and this thread as DNA, then this entire structure which is formed by coiling of DNA over the histone is known as nucleosome, my dear. Another very important concept. What is a nucleosome? Nucleosome is made up of DNA plus histone. Clear? Now, this histone protein over which the DNA molecule coils is not just made up of one polypeptide chain, beta. It is a octamer. It is made up of 4 plus 4, 8 polypeptide chains. Hai na? Har ek chain ke liye hum word use karte. It is a single unit. It is a mer. If I have 8 chains, 8 polynucleotides, then I am going to say that it is an octamer, right? 1 ke liye mono, 2 ke liye di, 3 ke liye tri, 4 ke liye tetra, 8 ke liye octa. So we say this histone protein is a histone octamer. Made up of 8 polypeptide chains, huh, such that 4 are present in the front, 4 are present at the back, and they are same. Har kisi ke do do units present hai. So I can say har kisi ka dimer present hai. Wo 4 polypeptide chains kya hai? 4 different type of histone molecules only. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 in the front, 4 at the back. So these are dimer. Dimer of 1 histone, dimer of 2nd histone, dimer of 3rd histone, dimer of 4th histone. Total 4 into 2, 8 molecules. What are these 4 different types of histone which join to form the histone octamer? One is H2A, the other is H2B, H3, H4. I have 4 different types of histone molecules which are present in doublets or dimers, H2A, H2B, H3, H4 into 2, 8 molecules of different types of histone joining together to form the histone octamer, which we represent as a single ball over which the DNA wraps, the DNA molecule wraps because of the positive charge of histone. The negatively charged DNA gets attracted to histone and coils around it, forming a nucleosome. But each nucleosome contains some limited number of the monomeric units of DNA, or we can say some limited length of DNA. As discussed, DNA is made up of many nucleotides, each nucleotide having a sugar, a nitrogenous base and a phosphate, right? And since it's a double helix, we can say ki there is a nitrogenous base present here, there is a nitrogenous base present here attached to a nucleotide. So at every point I can say I have a nitrogenous base pair, I have a nitrogenous base pair, I have a nitrogenous base pair. A ladder like structure which we say, a spiral ladder. There is some distance between each base pair forming the length of the DNA. How many base pairs coil over one histone octamer, my dear? See, we say 147 nitrogenous base pairs coil over one histone octamer. 1 nucleosome contains an histone octamer along with 147 nitrogenous base pairs of the length of DNA. Jo bhi DNA histone octamer ke upar coil kar raha hai, us DNA mein 147 nitrogenous base pairs hai, itni hi limited length hoti hai for one nucleosome. But beta, 147 base pairs to bahut kam hai. Our entire DNA has about 6.6 into 10 to the power 9 base pairs. If I talk of a human cell and the amount of nuclear material, genetic material which is made up of DNA present inside the nucleus of each cell, it is equal to 6.6 into 10 to the power 9 base pairs, right? So, in a human cell, the DNA contains 6.6 into 10 to the power 9 base pairs. Wo to 147 se bahut zyada hai. तो इसका मतलब जो ह्यूमन का डीएनए है जब वो पैक करेगा तो उसमें एक न्यूक्लियोसोम नहीं होगा, उसमें बहुत सारे न्यूक्लियोसोम होंगे, है ना? एंड ऑल दीज न्यूक्लियोसोम्स आर अटैच्ड टू ईच अदर, माय डियर. हाउ दे आर अटैच्ड टू ईच अदर? विद द हेल्प ऑफ अ लिंकर डीएनए. एवरी न्यूक्लियोसोम गेट सम स्पाइरल डीएनए and we seal this amount of DNA present on the histone with the help of a sealing histone. This sealing histone is a H1 histone. हमने octamer में use किए थे H2A, H2B, H3, H4 और जब हमने एक न्यूक्लियोसोम को राउंड राउंड कर दिया ओवर द हिस्टोन प्रोटीन देन वी से दैट आई एम गोइंग टू सील दिस डीएनए व्हिच इज कॉइल्ड ओवर हिस्टोन विद द हेल्प ऑफ अनदर टाइप ऑफ हिस्टोन कॉल्ड H1 हिस्टोन. लाइक दिस आई हैव मेनी न्यूक्लियोसोम्स प्रेजेंट इन अ ह्यूमन सेल while packaging of DNA, which are attached to each other. How are they attached to each other? With the help of certain linker DNA. This length of DNA which is attaching one nucleosome to the other nucleosome. Each nucleosome DNA is sealed by H1 histone. And this DNA is known as linker DNA. This DNA is known as linker DNA. Each molecule is known as nucleosome, which is equal to nothing but DNA plus a histone octamer. This joining of one nucleosome to another nucleosome accommodates the entire DNA and attains a morphology like there is a long length of DNA with many nucleosomes giving this entire length of packaging of DNA a beads on string appearance. Each nucleosome appear as a bead on string, and this string, my dear, is known as chromatin. So if you say that a prokaryotic cell has chromatin, it's wrong, because chromatin is formed of many nucleosomes attached to each other with linker DNA, and nucleosome has DNA associated with histone. But in a prokaryotic cell, you have no association of histone with DNA, so there is no chromatin. Chromatin is formed during packaging of DNA in a eukaryotic cell. This chromatin further coils into certain loose, certain condensed portions, forming lightly stained portions called euchromatin and densely packed darkly stained portions called heterochromatin, which organize themselves in a further compact structure called chromosome, my dear. We say this is entire packaging of DNA over histone, nucleosomes together into chromatin, chromatin into euchromatin and heterochromatin, coil many folds to form a rod like structure called chromosome, my dear. Euchromatin and heterochromatin further coil, leading to the formation of a structure called chromosome. Clear? We say euchromatin is a lightly stained, loose, functional portion of the DNA. Heterochromatin is densely packed, dark stained, non-functional portion of the DNA that is packed into chromosome. If I have to summarize the packaging of DNA in a human cell or the packaging of DNA in a eukaryotic cell, we can say that DNA coils over histone octamer to form structure called nucleosome. Nucleosomes join together to form a structure called chromatin, and chromatin organizes into euchromatin and heterochromatin portions of the chromosome. Negatively charged DNA coils over positively charged histone protein to form nucleosome. Nucleosomes are linked to each other by linker DNA to form a thread-like structure called chromatin, chromatin is organized into light stain, loosely packed and functional euchromatin and densely packed dark staining non-functional portion called heterochromatin. euchromatin and heterochromatin further coil to form a rod-like structure called chromosome, So if we have a 3-mark question, we can just write the text with a small flowchart that we have DNA plus histone leading to the formation of nucleosome, leading to the formation of chromatin and ultimately chromosome. We can label chromatin into 2 portions, can be either euchromatin or can be heterochromatin. If there is a neat, well-labeled diagram asked for the structure of a nucleosome, we can show the histone octamer along with the packed DNA sealed with H1 histone. If only asked with the help of a diagram, explain the packaging of DNA in a eukaryotic cell, we can show that there is a nucleosome which are attached to each other to form chromatin, a beads on string appearance that forms euchromatin, heterochromatin and ultimately chromosome. I hope packaging of DNA in a eukaryotic cell is all clear to all of you. Looking forward to see you more with more videos. Thank you so much.